Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to thank the organizers, Color Summer, and all the attendees here for taking your time out to attend this event. Some very illustrious names, brands, and of course, the overall media fraternity here. Thank you all for coming here. And special thanks to Varun. Varun is the second generation entrepreneur from the family of Pothys. How many of you don't know Pothys? Can't be, right? Do you think, Varun, that's because of the power of the media? Because you guys have been on the media for so many years. Your thoughts, why is it that nobody not knows Pothys? I mean, how big has media played such a big role?
Well, even though we our roots come from a very long time, in terms of media space, we've been very active pretty much from 1999, where that's where we came into Chennai. So, one of the very first speakers who was here, she was talking about market disruption and everything. So, when we came into Chennai in about 1999, we wanted to disrupt the market in some way that we saw a huge market in silk saris, where nothing was branded as such. You go to any store, they will call any silk sari Kanjivaram silk saris. So, what is Kanjivaram silk saris? What is Arni? There was never really a definition towards it. And hence, we started a portfolio, a brand name called Samudrika and Parampara, which was way back in about 2003-04 when I was still in college. Our association with media kind of started, kick-started towards there. And for about 15-17 years or so, we've been actively placed in the media. You could always see our ads every year, be it Diwali, be it Pongal, be it summer. We are always actively placed in all forms of media. So, as I said, it is a homegrown brand because of what we portrayed in the media as well. Yes.
Fantastic. I'm sure many of you would have been to the Usman Road, the retail hub of India, as I would say. And whenever I talk to people across the country, I say that come and stand on Usman Road for about 1 hour. And that's the place where you understand consumer psyche, consumer behavior. In that 500-600 meters, starting from Shiva Vishnu Temple all the way to Vivek's on the other side, or maybe slightly shorter as well, the daily business that happens is about 500 crores or more, perhaps, with all the kind of big names, small names, all the kind of businesses that happen. And then suddenly there is this towering structure, which is Pothys. Pothys is a household name as well. So, you've been one of the oldest or perhaps one of the strongest advertisers on television as well. So, tell us something about how the consumers have changed your advertising strategy. You've been running a lot of other advertisements and something specific to Dr. Kamal Haasan. I'll come to that separately. But outside of that, your journey of how you've been handling these ad films?
Our ad strategy pretty much from about 2004 to 11-12 was pretty much the same. It was always more inclined towards silk saris. And when Diwali comes, we used to release a new collection for, everybody wants to see new garments for Diwali. So, but if you've seen our strategy for the last three, maybe couple of years, during Adi, everybody knows about Adi Kalu, Kalivi or Adi Talubadi, where we give out discounts. 5 to 50%, and pretty much every retailer talks about it. But it was kind of losing its significance because, it was good 15 years ago when there was very select retailers doing it. But right now, everyone does it, and with e-commerce coming into the play, discount, it loses its significance. We went into different strategy of, okay, what do we do on a RD season? It was one of our main season, is that's when we came with the offers of 1+1, if you've heard about it, which is not really new in terms of branded menswear, but in terms of saris, nobody has really done it in a very successful way, kind of picked it up. In terms of summer, if you see, pretty much all the retailers who talk about, summer collections, Kulugulu summer, and this was pretty much churning out the same thing over and over again for a very, very, very long time. And you could see that there was a distinct spending power was completely different in terms of summer season because of schools and college fees and everything kind of hampers your whole spending power in the month of May. So what we last couple of years, we've been trying out something called economy offers or economy zones within the stores where we promote low price point goods. So we've changed our strategy in terms of what we've done before and what we've been doing right now. I mean, for Diwali, we've gone last couple of seasons, we've done matching, if you remember, where the whole family kind of comes up in a single color, promoting unity among the family, trying to spend Diwali as a whole family altogether.
Color coding and
color coding. And when you spoke about Mr. Kamal Haasan, if you remember, the very first ad with this is, you know, he talks about the things that we are supposed to be doing on a Diwali day is, you know, enna thechu kulikano, sweets aapadanom, vedi vedikano. Then he comes to the terrace and talks about, you know, and you want to do all these things and wear all these clothes and where do you buy these clothes? It's, you know, in a Rabi Prayamana kada, and that is Pothys. That's how we finish it. So, yeah.
So, since you already, I wanted to keep it for the sort of a climax or a grand finale, but since you already spoke about Dr. Kamal Haasan, and the whole ad was a single shot, right? I mean, it kind of
yes,
goes through
was,
in
yeah.
a particular
flow. It was
flow.
A 40-second single shot, yes.
Right, and yeah. Single shot is very famous in film making, and of course, he has done it many, many times, multiple times in many films, and of course, dance moves, you know, it's a very popular thing. So that's more technical, but on the commercial part, if I were to say Pothys before Kamal Haasan and Pothys after Kamal Haasan, that was the first time that he has actually done a ad film or probably a formal support, a paid commercial act, so to say. What was the positive, or if at all there was a negative impact for the brand after this ad campaign? I think that was 3 years back, right? 2016.
Yeah, yes. Right. Negatives, no, nothing much. One thing is we are not able to find any better ambassadors than Mr. Kamal Haasan. You kind of hit the peak there, and anybody who you choose next would be, I mean, what is even the point? You know, that's the first question when we comes into a marketing, you know, when we talk about it. In terms of a positive, you know, Pothys as a brand before Mr. Kamal Haasan, post Mr. Kamal Haasan, stands pretty much for the same. There's nothing different to it. But yeah, having him, and we are not able to look beyond him. That is probably because, you know, that's because our only concern right now, yeah.
Probably what I was trying to mean was Pothys was always seen more as a formal, aspiring middle class and a middle class brand, but after this campaign with Mr. Kamal Haasan, I have personally seen a lot of people visiting Pothys who would have never visited before. And that was because I think there was a bit of a glamour which came attached with that package as well. So, did you enhance your merchandise, your collection after the... So, you want to talk about that?
Absolutely. See, merchandise, a little bit, yes. We are, especially for the last 3-4 years, purely owing to, you know, the market circumstances and everything, we've always placed our products towards the, which gives you more margin, which other retailers would not be able to source them. And obviously, with Mr. Kamal Haasan in it, you would have that, he is more associated towards the top of the hierarchy, what you call in cinema, the A-class customers, A-class viewership, and yes, so to attract him, more higher priced merchandise was obviously displayed. And since he, the first commercial was during the Diwali, that's when the spending power is also much higher, you know, compared to rest of the year. Yes, we did.
And any particular reason why Pothys has not reused that engagement once again? Was he unwilling, or is it your...
No, see, once we wanted to sign him up, we were very sure that it has to be on a very short span. There is no point of using Mr. Kamal Haasan on a very long term, and there is only a very select message that you can, you know, obviously he cannot come and talk about products. He represents more of a brand and everything. So we didn't want to overuse him, use him correctly, and we were very sure when we saw the advertisement, this would click and it would get viral, and you would see n number of memes. There was, you know, parody videos of people, you know, imitating the same thing again and again. So even after, I mean, you said it was 3 years before, so you still remember it, and a lot of our consumers still remember it. I'm pretty sure another 5 years, 10 years down the line, I don't know, yeah, people would forget a lot of things, but this will always be remembered for.
Fantastic. How many of you have questions for Varun, for Pothys, for their? Work on your thoughts. I'm going to take a few more questions to him directly, and then we'll open it up for the audience as well. How many stores do you have now?
13 right now. 13. 1-3.
1-3. Across?
Across Tamil Nadu, one in Kerala, Pondicherry, and one in Bangalore.
So, how much of your marketing budgets would be for, say, media, which is television, etc., and print and outdoor?
Totally about 1.5% to 2% in total.
Okay, and we've been hearing a lot of you know, the cereals and all that that Mr. Anup made in the presentation. How much traction are you getting when you are associating with these kind of tele-serials which are like unending? I mean, what is the kind of top-of-mind recall for the brand?
See, as he also said, you know, there is not really a lot of creative content, so we are bound to obviously advertise in them as much as possible. But in the last, say, last couple of quarters, we've been moving away from, you know, the mainstream media purely because of, you know, online digital media advertising and OTT platforms as such. Not on a very heavy spending, but we've started experimenting with them purely because of its limitations also. It is still very urban based. And we still have huge operations down south of Tamil Nadu as well. But yeah, in future, the percentage of advertisements towards the new media would probably be increasing.
I was, again, about to ask, but you already opened it up. OTTs, that's the biggest flavor today. Everyone is talking about OTTs. So many series are being planned, and there are bin series across languages, across genres. Again, referring to Mr. Anup, he was talking about a lot of genres in which we don't have serials today, but a lot of series, you know, on OTT platforms, they come. So, how are you embracing the new digital, young age, 20 to 30 year old consumer, who is probably not wanting to watch a 32 inches LED TV, rather than prefers watching it on his or her screen? I mean, it could be a laptop or a mobile phone or an iPad or an equivalent. So how are you handling that shift?
As I said, the shift is definitely happening. We've experimented for a couple of seasons, and we found very good tractions also. Number one, it is well, we have metrics. You advertise on an OTT platform. Next day morning, they give you a metric of how many people actually watched it, how many people actually watched it for 25 seconds or 25%, how many people actually watched the ad for 50, 100, and so on. So the metrics is very helpful for a marketeer and for the brands also. And in terms of tele series and everything, where, as you said, there is n number of programs, you know, that is churning out the same content, this is also refreshing for any consumer, especially the 18 to 30 bracket. There's new content that comes up in TikTok, there's new content that comes up in Insta and all kind of social media platforms with OTT. We are actively looking, we've done collaborations with some YouTube bloggers where we're about 30, 35 year old housewives. They come to the store, take video of our products, they blast it, and the cost per view is absolutely peanuts. Where you have, that's a different content altogether when you see television per se. So these kinds of new contents are very new for us. We are also testing and trying it out. If successful, yes, we will roll it out on a major scale.
So so we can estimate that you're going to spend more, invest more rather, and learn or probably unlearn from the digital media as well.
Absolutely.
Coming to advertising itself on television especially, there are an estimated about 50-55 odd Tamil channels plus the local cable and all of that stuff. Of these, about a dozen of them are only in the news space. And everyone is breaking some news or the other at every instant. So how is your split between a GEC versus a, say, for example, a news channel specifically? How boring or how monotonous is it to see the same content, but yet come and go in between for your brand? I mean, have you thought?
So we segregated in such a way that, you know, we don't put all our eggs in one basket also. But in terms of local cable channels, our spending is very, very limited. Well, with advent to how the mainstream media is doing right now, our spending is very limited. And with Dish and everything coming up, you know, very huge in the last couple of years, it's a no-brainer as well. In terms of the news channels and the regular Suns and the Vijays and everything, we make sure that we are present in pretty much all, but obviously not putting all the baskets in one also.
So, between the traditional ones, the big four as we call, and the underdogs, what's your split currently? I mean, are you experimenting with a lot of new channels, upcoming channels, or are you still sticking to the safe zone with the big four?
I think safe zone would be the answer. Still, a small amount of experiment does go on, but yeah, as you said, we are more comfortable also. and trying and doing pretty much what is tested. And
so Colors team, if you're here, you know whom to catch. I'm not saying you're an underdog, but most of their spins are getting into top four. My last question to you, and then we'll open up to the floor as well, is that how have you seen in the 15 years that you've been associated with the business, how have you seen media spends evolve overall for your category, which is family dressing, if I would call it at that level, in the mainstream media? I mean, has it evolved? Has it matured? Has it hit the peak? Is it falling down? What are your closing comments?
In terms for us, we've always maintained about, as I said, that 1.5% to 2%. But in general, if you look at other homegrown retailers, they have definitely bought on the spending. You could see that. There were a few homegrown players from Coimbatore, Trichy, local Tamil Nadu, everywhere, where you would see their advertisements in even, even Sun TV or any related channels for about 6-7 years ago. And they are reduced their spending, at least in the mainstream advertisement. Obviously, when it comes to cost cutting, that is that kind of eats you a big chunk. So it is a very easy expenditure for them to cut it down immediately. But as far as Pothys is concerned, we have pretty much maintained. We've always been on the media as such for about 2 to 3 seasons in a year.
So this format is a fireside chat, which is not like a long tete-a-tete that we carry on for 1 hour. So I'm going to keep it brief. I'm going to open the questions to the floor. Maybe 2 or 3 quick questions. Broadcasters, advertisers, media agencies, enthusiasts, if you can switch on the lights and open the floor, please. Yeah, please. Can you?
Excuse me. First, I'll finish my questions. What is your hits here? How do you encounter the online sales happening? Your presence here right now online is not that great, actually. But is there any strategy you're going to take it up in future?
I'm sorry, in terms of online, meaning
online
your
sales,
digital or
Pothys as a brand online. Is offline. As of Pothys is a offline stores more than online stores, actually.
Oh, yes, you're talking about e-commerce.
Yeah, e-commerce.
I'm sorry, you're talking about e-commerce of Pothys?
How? Yeah.
Okay. We still have, obviously, a live site. Not a very big business as such. Traditionally selling, with the big giants out there, our spending is pretty much zero, is what I should be saying. We do have a live site where we ship mostly to foreign consumers.
My point is there any challenge for you from the e-commerce?
To our traditional businesses?
Yes.
In terms of apparels, yes and a no. Yes, in terms of bucket size of less than 1,000, yes. Be it Amazon, Flipkart, or any Myntra or anyone, they have definitely specialized in the sub-1,000 rupee category. Anything more than that, no. Still, they are finding it a bit difficult to, if you want to, probably in menswear, yes, but probably not in saris and womenswear, especially more traditional womenswear, no.
So I think that answers the question. Yes, sir.
So my name is Sudhakar. This question is regarding Pothys as a brand. You have a brand called Pothys, which is predominantly known across Tamil Nadu. Now, you also have one more brand, which is called Oto, which is positioned as a ready-made shirt or ready-made menswear. So how do you see Oto and Pothys complementing each other? Because whenever you speak about Pothys, then Oto takes a lower position, because Pothys is a very big brand as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned. Now, Oto has to go pan-Tamil Nadu, because it is not focused only for Tamil Nadu. So what is your view on creating multiple brands in the textile segment?
Before that, for the benefit of many other people, there's a brand called Oto, O-T-T-O. Dalkir Salman was one of your earlier, he continues to be your brand ambassador as well. So it was an in-house private label brand of sorts, and then it was probably demerged, and now it is an independent apparel brand, and it's probably available in about 200 stores across the country. So I think the gentleman is asking you to answer how they complement or repel each other from the main brand of Pothys.
No, there's no repelling. Complementing in such that, in terms of merchandise display and everything, obviously preference is given more towards private label, and we've done the same as well. Oto always, you know, it's much closer to our heart. And in terms of consumer, since quick through about, you know, a quick info about Oto also, Oto is the fastest selling 600-700 rupees sub shirts category in the whole of South India. I'm sorry, whole of India actually, in terms of units as well as turnover. So Oto is not really a small brand. For its brand, Oto has a very big presence. In terms of branding, well, Pothys is known for wide collection at very sustainable prices, and Oto pretty much does that in the category that it actually caters to. Market leader in both, how Oto is a market leader in its category, we believe Pothys is also market leader in our category. So both are very self-sustaining and complements each other as well.
To answer your question, so I don't want to talk real numbers, but Oto is in the making of a 300 crore per year sort of a brand.
Yes.
So it's not a small brand. It's not a Teenagar brand. I mean, it's that big a brand. There is a huge fan following for Oto. It's inching closer to 300 crores in turnover, not the valuation. I think that will be probably much higher. So last question, if you can have any other women audience, I'll probably be willing to take one more question. Yes, sir.
Yeah. What type of pricing strategy you adopted to overcome the competitors?
Presently, we are actually moving towards a bit on the higher margin business, purely because of competition from local international players, actually, pan-India players. You see, 5-7 years ago, you would never really imagine Max or a Reliance Trend or FBB coming into a town like Tirunelveli, where their presence is increasing year on year, where they are more concentrated on the basics of clothing. You go there, you buy a tees for 125, 150, you buy a shirt for 300, you buy a trouser for 400. So they've captured, you know, that segment of the market very cleverly, whereas we are consciously moving towards the other end of the market where margins are higher. We are more value-added products in terms of ethnic wear as well as ready-made wear. Yes.
Any one woman audience who would want to ask a question? We have a gentleman who decorates and makes women look good. Blessing Manigandan from Essentials. Yes, please go ahead.
Hi, bro. So I want to know where you park your marketing budgets, like in which medium, radio or TV or magazine or what is the percentage?
Right now it's about 50% for tele, about 30% for newspaper, and the rest 20% is for others, pretty much.
Great. Thank you so much, Varun. We've elongated the session a little, delayed because of unforeseen circumstances. Thanks so much for your patience.
Thank you.
Thank you, wonderful audience, for all the questions, and really appreciate everyone's time. Thank you.
Thank you,
organizers.